Hello everyone, today we're going to look at the AI integration in Enterprise Architect, so utilizing LLMs to accelerate the modeling process. So first up, why not to use AI to completely model your system? First, it doesn't have a whole lot of business domain specific context about your business. It doesn't know the intricate ins and outs of exactly how your business runs. It can only operate in a generic and generalized matter. It has a hard time handling ambiguity, and it can only work with the information that's been given, and it doesn't know any better. So humans are much better at running workshops and clarifying questions and really digging down to the single source of truth that entails what your model needs to capture. If you just relied on an LLM to give that information, then you'll have big holes in that. It has a lack of creativity and innovation. Yes, it's pretty smart with coming up with ideas, but it is really limited to what it has been trained on. Sometimes out-of-the-box solutions might need to be invented, and only a human at the moment can really come up with those ones. It has a black box problem. So if you rely on an LLM to populate your entire model, then you yourself will be unable to explain what has gone in there and why. It really does require a human interaction in between to put the information in, just so you know and you can explain what's happening inside your model. Relying on an LLM to populate your entire model has a lack of a human in the loop for oversight. So AI can drift in its meaning over time as you start adding things to it, especially this process is going on over months. So you need a human regular checking the information that's coming out of these LLMs before you put them into your model to ensure accuracy and consistency and stop that drift. There's also security and privacy risks. So you don't want to be sending sensitive business data to public machines. It's just not good business practice, especially if they're reliant on, or you're reliant on those, that information for your business edge. And the LLMs, or the AI, has a hard time reaching consensus to facilitate a true picture of a story. So it can't read the room, it can't seek idea from others, it can't ensure that all stakeholders are happy and on the same page, especially when those people respond with facial expressions and other quirks that the AI is just not going to see. But on the other hand, why should you use AI to help build your model? It is really good at accelerating the initial modeling phase. So translating requirements, rapid prototyping, and all that sort of wonderful stuff. Drawing on the models that it has been trained on to provide information that you yourself might not have thought of. It can improve data consistency, so it can export information to you using different modeling standards, different naming conventions, different formatting, and things like that. So it can really produce consistent results of the data, of the output, for you to consume. It enables intelligent analysis and insights, so data-driven decisions that it can do way much more efficient than what a human can do. So you can provide it emails and documents and policies, and it can then consume that information and produce a final report or a final output that takes all those things into consideration in a much faster time than what a human would be able to do themselves. It can help facilitate your requirements creation process, so leveraging those large volumes of unstructured data and then building requirement sets out of those. It can also augment the creative and innovation design. So it can be a powerful brainstorming partner, something to bounce ideas off and use in a back and forth nature to really flesh out your system. So what does Enterprise Architect bring on the AI integration? We have ability to do discussions and chats. We have workbench integrations. We have context sensitive keywords. It puts you in control. It gives you 100% ownership and sign-off of the information that goes into the model before signing off as your formal model. So 100% creative freedom for that one. It also has a whole bunch of tools for rapid model creation. So let's dive in and take a look at that now. Okay, in this demo here, we're going to build up a model of a light aircraft airport, and we're going to use AI to help this. So first, we're going to create a new AI discussion, and then we're going to paste in the premise here of what we're going to do. So we'll just call it flight school, and then we'll create a new discussion with the AI, and then we'll paste in this description. So description is basically, I need to create a model of a light aircraft airport with a flight school. I'd like to start simple and then add more detail over time. First, like I said, 10 requirements just to work, and then feel free to ask me any questions as we go. So we'll send that off to the LLM, and it should give us a reasonably comprehensive answer in return. So there it is. It's given us 10 requirements now that you should, or that could be basically used for a light aircraft airport. So first we're going to move these to our workbench so we can start analyzing and manipulating this data. So we'll push to my workbench, and then we'll open that up. And you can see here we have the same text that was returned by the LLM. So right now we're going to use one of EA's features to create elements from this text. So we'll sit here and create a new element. We'll set it to a requirement. Just via the requirements menu there. And once we do this the first time, we won't need to do that again. And now we can select the rest of this text and then push that to the notes of the requirement. This gives us the option to vet the text as it comes in. So we might want to update this if we want, if the basic runway description that the LLM gave us was not accurate. So now we can go through and do the same process for the rest of these requirements. And it's a simple matter of creating the element, giving it a specific name, and then pushing the notes after we check them into that element. Okay, we've just used the power of video editing to jump to the last one here. So we'll create our final requirement for the first part of this system. Okay, now all of our 10 requirements have been quickly created using the push to workbench and then creating elements and then pushing to notes. Okay, so let's take our runway and now let's flesh out greater requirements to the runway, so the sub requirements for it. In this case, we're going to write a very specific request to the AI, and that is for our runway. Here's are a few specific details that we have. So we'll talk about the type of runway that's going to be, whether it's paved or asphalt or what have you. And we're also going to talk about the types of aircraft that are going to be landing on this runway. Now, as the modeler, I am not privy to the specifics of the requirements of those aircraft. That's something that I'll need to go back and look up. However, the AI can give me a good head start on the types of information or general information about what that aircraft supports. And as you can see, ChatGPT has returned runway length, width, and other varying qualities that is going to be required to suit an aircraft of that caliber, the Cessna 425. Again, we'll push these to our workbench so it retains everything we've done there, and we can run through the same process where we can take certain parts of the text and then create a requirement out of those and then push the rest to the notes. So it doesn't have to be the name that they've selected. So in this case, let's grab some of the text from the notes here, which is more in tune with what a requirement should say. Then we can grab the notes and push them all into that element, obviously checking them for accuracy as we go. So again, we'll select some of the text from the notes, which is more of a requirement. So in this case, a minimum width of 75 feet. Create that as a requirement. Then push the entire text for that requirement into its notes. And we can do this for the other ones as well. Now we can link these requirements up to the parent requirement, because obviously all these are sub requirements of the runway requirement. Okay, so now we've added a title and laid out our diagram a little bit better. What we're going to do now is go back to the LLM and, with our discussion, ask it to generate us a list of glossary terms that we've used in these requirements so far. So obviously glossary is important, so everyone's on the same page with their terms. And this is something that the AI systems can do very well, crunching information and pulling out data-driven insights from that. So in this case, I've asked it to go through all the nouns in our requirement so far and create glossary terms for that. And just like magic, it's done the work for us. So once again, we'll push that to the workbench and we'll use the same approach of highlighting text. And in this case, instead of selecting create element, we will create a glossary term. And we can do the same for the next one. So we'll copy the definition, select the title, create a glossary definition out of that, and then paste the definition in. Again, we can adjust this definition based on our specific context for our specific business. But once these glossary definitions are in place, in all text in Enterprise Architect, they'll come up and you can mouse over them to get a description of the word in the glossary. Cool, and once they're finished, if we go to the notes, we can see that now these guys have descriptions that we can mouse over. Okay, now that our glossary is done, let's use the chat feature instead of the discussions feature to do one-off prompts to the LLM. So in this case, we're going to introduce one of the new keywords, which is hash diagram hash. And this allows you to send a copy of the diagram to the LLM so it can understand what you have. So in this case, we're going to say, based on the diagram we have, can you suggest one or more requirements I should add? So it's going to take that, look at the diagram and say, yes, in this case, you probably need the weather station and here's the details for it. So again, I can push that to my workbench, bring it down here, check the information is correct, and then use our create element feature to add that to the diagram. So this is very useful for taking existing systems and using the LLMs to see if there's any gaps in the knowledge or gaps in the model. And that can identify that quite quickly. Okay, so what we're going to do now is select one of these other elements. So let's say hangers. And now we're going to use the second keyword that Enterprise Architect has for the LLMs, and that's the hash element keyword. So what I'm going to say is, based on this hangers requirement, what are some use cases that could be used to fulfill those requirements? And I'll use the hash element keyword to send only this information to the LLM. So this way I'm not exposing my entire organization's model to a public service, just this very specific piece of information. And based on that, I get some very useful information back on how we can continue our modeling efforts. So we'll send that off. And the LLM has returned with this description of a use case, the actors, preconditions, main flows, and etc. And we can model that up in the same way using a use case diagram inside Enterprise Architect. So we can use these keywords in different ways as well to interrogate the model. For instance, if I asked the LLM how many elements are on this diagram, it should be able to parse that information and give us a good rundown. So that way you can use it to understand legacy models that you have in your repository as well. So what we're seeing today is Enterprise Architect's communication with an AI system. It allowed us rapid model creation of elements and glossary items. It provided a workbench to help us scrutinize the information that comes from the LLMs. We've had the hash keywords of hash diagram and hash element to send model bits to the AI system and get intelligent information back. And we've also used keywords to understand current models, where we can improve, where we can add stuff, and also how to understand legacy models. This is just the first iteration of AI integration with Enterprise Architect, and this will continue to develop over time. So visit www.sparxsystems.com for all the latest updates.